Hi everyone, this is just a kick-off video just to start the new year, and I just want to use this opportunity to thank everybody for all the messages, you know, via email, in the comment section, you know, and just the tremendous encouragement that I've received from people. Many people have shared a word with me that God has given them to in connection with us or in connection with South Africa, myself. And I really appreciate every single comment and every single email. And I just want to remind everybody, our comment section is not actually closed. It is held for review and we don't release them to the public. So whatever you post in the review section or in the comment section, we see, I read it personally, but it's not visible for other people, and for reasons I have mentioned before, in that we do not want this channel to become a platform for a lot of people to share their views and beliefs, especially when it comes to a lot of the conspiracy theories as well as some of the end time theology. And when people post comments that are, for example, racist or hate speech or whatever, it puts the channel at risk and it puts all our hard work at risk. The other thing that I just want to do right now is just to thank everybody that has contributed during the time period of this channel existing. We've been quite surprised by that, because we never, you know, sort of wanted to promote in any way or make money. We have a few sponsors that sponsored the channel, but obviously there are expenses that come up in that. And it's just amazing how people, without us saying a word, people have been giving just as they've been led by the Spirit of God, and that, and it's been incredible how timely a lot of those contributions were. You know, just to give you an example, at the beginning of 2020, we had to pay for the license for the software that we use here, and the rand dollar, and this in this case it's an Australian company, the rates are not that good, the rand to Australian dollar, so it was quite pricey. And we tried to see if we can't maybe negotiate with them just to give us a temporary license until we have sufficient money, because the deadline was coming up and we needed the funding to do that. And in a period of 3 months that we had, we received enough contributions to be able to pay for that license that we needed, which is just absolutely incredible, you know. And so I just want to thank everybody for the giving, for the prayers, like I said, for the word, for everything. We cannot do this without you, and we appreciate every one of you that help us to keep this channel on the air. It's going to be a very difficult year. I think the thing that has changed dramatically for me is, for me, it's always been, you know, prophetic, in the sense that when I started to prophesy really publicly about South Africa in 1997, it was all in the future. You know, everything was still going to happen, and every year I would wonder, you know, am I missing it? All my predictions about, for example, the ANC and the road that the ANC would take us on. In 1995, I began to speak just within our own framework of our own church, and that about the ANC that would basically cause South Africa to be bankrupt. And so now it is different. Now I prophesy of what's not a really prophecy. A lot, some of the things are still prophetic, and the things that I'm going to be sharing now in the first 2-3 months of this year, I think for a lot of people is going to be a game changer as far as their end time theology is concerned. I'm going to show you some things from the Bible that's missed, that is totally, people read over it. You know, I want you to think of it this way. When you have sort of made up your mind about something, or in other words, if you have a certain paradigm or, sort of favorite view that you have on end time theology, what ends up happening is that your brain becomes like a filter. And so, some people have the ability to receive new knowledge, and that filter doesn't filter out everything. And so they look at it and examine it and make the necessary adjustment, which is the way it should be. But unfortunately, most people, that filter filters out or changes what they hear. So what will happen is they'll hear me say something about end times, and because of what they already believe, it will automatically be just a thing of rejecting what I'm saying as not right, as false. On the other side, many people are hearing basically what they want to hear, and so it is quite alarming to see how many people actually don't hear what I say and hear what they think I say. And it's quite something when I point out to people and say, but I never said that. Yeah, but you said it in this video. I said, okay, go watch it again. And then they watch the video a second time. And luckily, some of those people have the decency to come back to me and say, sorry, we didn't hear that part, or I don't know how I missed that. And unfortunately, that happens to all of us to some extent. We do that. And the things that I'm going to be sharing in the beginning part of this year is really going to sort of pave the way for you to be able to understand prophecy in the Bible and end times in that. And I think you're going to be amazed at what the prophetic picture that the Bible actually paints about end times. As I've shared these things with many people over the years, it's always the same thing where people are so excited by what they've heard, because it shows the greatness of God. It shows how God is still in control, and how the way things are going to be playing out in the next couple of years was written by the prophets, unfortunately misunderstood by many of the preachers and teachers. But it's there, it's black and white. And when I show these things to you, you will be amazed at just how clear it is in the Bible and how much has been filtered out or changed because of existing paradigms. It's no longer really prophecy to say that 2021 is going to be an extremely difficult year. The job losses are not over. In other words, we saw small to medium businesses taking a major knock last year. Apparently, somewhere in the region of 53% of small to medium businesses closed their doors. Fortunately, many guys are trying again, and many have managed to almost like resuscitate their businesses. So it's not all a loss. But for many people, it was the end of the road. Now, what we're going to see in 2021 is the bigger businesses folding, many of them. Okay, also because of debt. Debt is going to be the major factor. The other one is COVID-19. The other one is just absolutely terrible economy. The situation with under the governance of the ANC. And reason why these companies have been able to still keep going is because the banks stand to lose a lot more, and so the banks were willing to extend loans and give breathers and all this kind of stuff to a lot of these companies. But unfortunately, a lot of these companies have made a lot of additional debt, and look with what's happening now in 2021. This COVID thing is not over, not by far. And so with that additional debt, what they've done is they've extended maybe the life of that business, but in the process have shot themselves in the foot and basically just secured the collapse of the many of those businesses. Now, I'm not saying all of the businesses will fail, but that's pretty much what we're going to see in 2021. The other thing that we're going to really witness this year is how things just come apart politically, how the whole thing of people, the rioting, the looting, and that is really going to escalate tremendously in this year. I think a lot of people don't understand what I'm saying when I say where things are going to go in South Africa. In 97, I said that it would reach a point where it would seem as if all is lost. In other words, that's how bad it's going to be. I made certain predictions about that more people will be unemployed than employed. And we're there already, and moving even further into that. But at the same time, we're also going to be seeing more and more this sub-economy emerging and people beginning to establish ways of trading and that in spite of. Okay, so there's going to be a lot of ingenuity, there's going to be a lot of clever things that people are going to do in order to just keep on functioning in that, which is going to be the survival of South Africa. You know, it's one of the things that I saw very, very clear, and that is that the big companies are not is not what's going to pull us through. The big commerce is not what's going to pull us through. What's going to pull us through is literally the man on the street, the small guys that do whatever they do, just to get through things, just to provide for their families, and unknowingly actually establishing this sub-economy. And once we get through this, then we're going to see how the sub-economy is going to literally launch a whole new era of business and that in South Africa. But we're not there yet. It is still a way off. There's still many political changes that have to take place, governance changes that have to take place in that. Now, a lot of people ask me and they say, but what about the end of the world? We've been told that it's going to be the end of the world. Now you talk about a future for South Africa and everything. As you watch the videos that I'm going to be bringing on End Times, you will begin to see where South Africa fits in globally. And for people overseas and that, I'm moving into that territory now where a lot of the things that I share prophetically will not just be for South Africa, but for America, for Europe, for Canada, for New Zealand, for Russia, different countries. And I will be giving you an indication of what you can look for as far as certain movements and that are going to be taking place between nations and alliances that are going to be formed based on what scripture tells us. And so South Africa fits into that picture. So yes, there's tough times ahead. Yes, there's going to be a time of shaking commercially and everything. We are going to witness the collapse of the world financial system, basically, because of all the debt, because of all the corruption, because of everything like that. You see, the thing that we miss is that God doesn't build on something that's corrupt. So God will not establish a new government built upon another government that is corrupt or upon a political system that's corrupt. God doesn't work that way. God brings that which is ungodly to an end. And then on the ashes, in other words, when there's nothing left, God then builds the new thing. And so that is pretty much what we're going to see in South Africa. It is what we're going to see in Europe. It's what we're going to see in America. Is this thing where it's almost going to seem as if globally things are just literally falling apart. Tensions within nations, it's going to become so severe that it's almost going to look like nations are at war with themselves. Okay, we're going to witness that in America, and we're going to witness that in many of the European countries, and it's even going to spill over into nations like Australia. Okay, it is going to be chaotic, and there's going to be different things driving this. So, in other words, on the one side, we're going to see a religious component, in other words, where things are going to become very, very tense on that front. And so there's going to be this pulling to all sides, on the one side, the Muslims, on the other side, sort of the New Agers, on the other side, Judaism, on another side, Christianity, and everything else that's in between. And then on the other side, there's going to be the whole thing of war over land. In other words, that is, we're going to see it increasingly over here in South Africa. We're going to see it in Africa and then spill over into Europe. And that the whole Gog Magog war that is described in Isaiah has to do with land and has to do with religion. Okay? That is it. That is basically what it's all about. And the Bible tells us what the outcome of that's going to be. And so we're going to be looking at that. What exactly did the prophet say about the outcome of that? And then, of course, why it has to happen. You see, everything that God does is strategic. Every single thing. And God even uses the schemes of the ungodly and the plans of the ungodly and different nations and their different things in it to bring about his purposes and his plans. At the end of the day, I want you to think of what God is going to be doing globally as a game of poker. Now, I'm not a big person when it comes to playing game or cards or any games for that matter. But when I was younger, we used to play a little bit of poker. And, you know, you've got this thing where you bluff and you pretend that you've got a good hand and that in order to raise the stakes on the table. And then either the person with the highest hand will win that will be the taking, or alternatively, the person that bluffs the best will actually get it because other people fold. And then so oftentimes the person that didn't even have the best hand wins, but everybody else was convinced that they did have the best hand. And that's, you know, it's sort of this game of on one side bluffing, on the other side having a good hand. Now, God has the highest hand, which normally would be a royal flush. So I want you to think of it in that way. The nations are all playing this game, and the nations all think that they have the biggest hand, the best hand in the game. But at the end of the day, God holds the final hand, and he's playing the nations against one another. And at just the right time, he is going to play his hand, and it's going to be so incredible, and nobody's going to see it coming. Now, that hand that God is going to play has to do with the restoration of the house of Israel, not the Jews, not the land of Israel as we know it, but the restoration of the house of Israel as described by Isaiah and described by Ezekiel and many of the other prophets. And that is going to be that hand that God is going to play. The Bible makes it very, very clear that Israel, the house of Israel, the fully restored Israel, will rule on the earth and will represent Jesus, the Messiah, in governance in every respect. Okay? In Acts 1 verse 6, the disciples asked Jesus this question. They said, Lord, will this be when the kingdom is restored to Israel? They knew that it was coming. They knew about this time where the kingdom would be restored to Israel and the rulership would be restored to Israel. And that is part of what we're going to see play out. And I will give you a tremendous amount of detail about this, the promises that were made to Abraham and what was really said to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, as well as the blessing that Jacob spoke over Ephraim and Manasseh and how that plays out. You will see how much detail is lost due to prevailing theology that is within churches. Okay, so that is just to sort of give you some idea of where we're headed now in this 2021 as far as this channel is concerned, what I'm going to be sharing with you, and what we're going to see play out. You know, I'm going to be doing another short video just on COVID-19 just to sift a lot of the stories from, you know, and the false information from the true information and that, and what's busy happening in South Africa. The information that we have that is medical information from hospitals. And all I want to say to you at this point of time is be careful. Don't listen to the guys that tell you there is no such thing as COVID, or that tell you that it's a ploy. It's just a plan by the ANC, basically take South Africa captive and to do a military state and all this kind of stuff. You know, be very careful who you listen to, what you listen to, and stay safe. What I'm going to be showing you is that this virus is serious, and this other strain that we have now, or variant that we have in South Africa, it's not looking good. But there is some good news, and that is that I did have God show me something about a breakthrough that's going to come. And I actually saw in a vision a young virologist jump up out of her chair and run over to what I think was her superiors and It was a woman with long brown hair, and she had found something about this virus that everybody else had missed. Okay, so stay safe, you know, keep to the regulations, make sure that, you know, you don't, in a, like what's happening to many people now, where entire families are becoming sick, and that just simply because people think that it's not serious, and you know, they compare it to normal flu and that, and it's not like normal flu, trust me. In other words, there's some information that if you had to know it, you wouldn't sleep at night. And you know, I work with the statistics, I work with the stuff that I receive and that, and I will be sharing some of that with you just to help you to basically manage your own life and your family's life to make sure that you're safe. That's all for now. May God bless you.